good, everybody? It's your boy, Shane Dude Jackson, back at it again with another episode of the Celebrity Junk. Dima, white folks music. So check this out, right? Matt Barnes is actually from the city of Sacramento. I'm just a year younger than him. I was there when he was the Sacramento Bees Player of the Year in 1998. We were in the same league, the Capital Athletic League. I went to Grant High School, same school as Dante Stallworth and Ontario Smith. And he went to Dale Campbell High School. So he's a legend in our city. Had an okay basketball career, not as great as we all thought he would. But he's even having a better post career. He's more known now than he was in the league. He has an awesome podcast with Steven Jackson. But here's what Matt Barnes is still known for. He's the best simp in the entire nation. He keeps getting with single moms, Anansa, who he's back with now. But the worst choice that he ever made was getting married or having a baby with Gloria Govan. Okay? Now Gloria Govan is basically explosive. You know, she had even been charged with felony child endangerment, okay? And so she actually lost custody of their kids after the battle, but not before she was dating Derek Fisher. Now stop the show. Derek Fisher was not only a former teammate of Matt Barnes, but then his coach on the New York Knicks. And guess what Gloria Govan was doing while Matt Barnes was playing for the Knicks and Derek Fisher was his coach? Can I get a booty clapping sound? Yeah, that's right. His wife was screwing Derek Fisher.
Bruh.
And not only screwing Derek Fisher, bringing his kids around Derek Fisher. So much so that Derek Fisher and Matt Barnes kind of got into a little fighting sound, Zima. Right? It was all over the internet. And then it was going crazy and all of that. So Matt Barnes was looking really, really bad out there. Him and Derek Fisher has a lot of bad bloods. But hey, Matt Barnes didn't want his kids around Derek Fisher. And she said, nothing you can do about it. I'm going to have my kids around whoever I want. Fine. Let's kind of fast forward, Dima. Let's fast forward to this birthday party that he had with Anansa Sims. Now, Anansa was married before to somebody. She's a plus size model. And they had this, you know, birthday party that they threw for, Carter and Isaiah, something like that, right? Three of these kids, they're having a blended family thing. So they have Matt Barnes' children, her children. I don't know what they have together. But this is what Anansa Sims put on her Instagram, celebrating these children's birthdays party. Dating music! Happy 13th birthday, Carter and Isaiah. Three kings' birth on one special day. I'm so grateful to have you two loving lights in my life. Four different parties in one day, but us parents worked together to pull it off and made sure David, Carter, and Isaiah all felt loved, supported, and celebrated. Hashtag family over everything. Right? So give her a round of applause, Zima, for that support. But then Gloria Govan, who, remember, doesn't like Matt Barnes' new baby mama, and stop the show. It was after Gloria Govan started screwing his coach, Derek Fisher. Gloria Govan saw this Instagram post and she said this. Angry music! Okay, now it's just becoming too much. I've asked you before, leave my kids out of your false narrative. Stop the show. You should have thought about that before you left your man to go fuck his coach. But now you forgot all about that. Cool. Angry music! You know fully well my kids' birthday celebration had absolutely nothing to do with you or your son! At this point, this shit is just flat out weird. Stop the show. Well, you wouldn't have to deal with that if you wouldn't have left Matt Barnes to go screw his coach. Booty clapping sounds. Angry music. Your obsession with my kids is awkward and crazy. I've tolerated long enough. Stop the show. If you wouldn't have been screwing his coach and having your kids around another man that he had no idea about, it wouldn't have been a problem. But since you did it and now you're getting the same energy back, you have a problem.
Angry Music, your whole Super Mommy, Stepmom, Blended Family bullshit is hilarious. My kids tolerate you because I raised them well.
Stop the show. You were also having your kids around Derek Fisher, who was your, you know, baby daddy's coach and ex-husband's coach. You didn't care about that. Booty clapping sounds.
But don't get things twisted. They don't F with you or your kids.
Okay, we'll start right there. Stop right there. These are the Hellraisers I talked about in our community, okay? Ones who go out and raise hell with other men and have no problem with it. But when it's on them, they're the victim. They're the victim. And see, here's what Matt Barnes' baby mama drama is proving about modern women. They can dish it. Some of them cannot take it. And see, these little jabs that she's getting right now from Anansa Sims, that baby mama stuff. Now, Anansa knows what she's doing. She's irking her. She's pissing her off. But if you didn't want to worry about that, you wouldn't have been fucking Matt Barnes' coach, Derek Fisher, and having your kids around him. That's exactly how he felt when you had your kids around him, taking photos with him and doing stuff like that. But I guess it's because, you know, you love Derek Fisher or you like him and your kids like him. It's okay to do that, right? But you can't do it with his girl. See, here's the problem with messy divorces and messy relationships, okay? You see, if it's all about making your family what it is, then it's fine. But see, the thing about it is you think you're gonna have your cake and eat it too. And there are no solutions. As Thomas Sowell says, there are trade-offs. Men understand this a lot more so than I believe that women do. Because see, as men, we understand that there are certain things that we just can't do. Certain things that either we're gonna have to give this up or give that up, but it's gonna be one or the other. We can't have everything at the same time. This was evident when Kevin Samuels was talking about this during the Brittany Renner video. Hey, we can't have everything and have it at the same time. It's just not logical. It's just not feasible. You just can't do it. It doesn't make any sense, right? So this is the things that we're talking about right now in Black America. But the issue comes is that women believe that they can do whatever they want and they're not gonna have any effects of that. There are always side effects for what you do. For every action, there is a reaction. And when you decide that you're no longer gonna be with your child's father, you can't control who he deals with after that. I think a lot of times ladies wanna be able to control how things are gonna be. Just like, you know, if you break up with a chick and you guys know, or she breaks up with you, she wants to break up with you so you can remain friends, right? So then she can have access to you just in case it doesn't work out, whatever she wants to do, and have an option to come back. But does she ever think that, you know, you won't come back and you're gonna deal with somebody else and you will never ever talk to her again? She never conceives that, because in her mind she should be able to do whatever she wants to do and there's no punishment for it. Can I get a dun 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 sound effect? Let me just talk about this, right? And for you other guys out there, be careful for who you procreate with. You don't want to end up like Matt Barnes, getting, you know, messy ladies pregnant and going through this bullshit and, you know, making all that money and still you're dealing with, you're not dealing with the best quality, right? So guys, what do you think? It's your boy, O'Shea Duke Jackson, back at it again with another episode of The Celebrity Junk. I really appreciate you for all that you do. Subscribe, hit the bell, check out the first clip at the top. And as you know, the buffoonery remains at an all-time high. I'm out.